Okay, so this is an example problem we did in class. Let's now go ahead and employ the new concept that we talked about, which are the angles of repose and the angles of friction, and the angle of friction to help solve this problem. And this time, remember in class we said there are several scenarios without friction on the wall, with the frictions on the wall, and so forth. So this time I'm going to solve the problem assuming that there is friction. So when we're pushing this sledges up, this particular block and this particular block will be pushed all the way up against the wall, okay? And so this is something I said I promise I will do during the lecture. It's clear, actually it's not clear from the problem description how they wanted to do it. If this appears on the final, which I don't think I'll do a wedge problem on the final. I may ask you to sketch the three-body diagrams, but I won't ask you to solve for the whole thing. But if I do ask you to do that, I will make clear that whether the wall is a frictionless wall or the wall has friction on it. But we're going to employ angle of and repose for these two particular problems. What exactly does that mean? That simply means that we know that since impending motion is something that we are going to be applying for this particular case. So when you have an impending motion, that means that let me just give you an example. Let's say I can draw my normal force here, and I know if this is going to be pushed up, my friction will be heading this way, mu s n. Instead of sketching my free body diagram that way, I'm going to sketch it so that it is shown as a resulting force, okay? And the resulting force will be like that, R1. And this is my angle of repulse, which is equal to the angle that is equivalent to the static friction coefficient. As we discussed, here's my 400 pound, and my block is going to get pushed up. So here again, I could have drawn like this, M2, and this particular block is going to be sliding inwards, so impending motion is that one. Therefore, if I were to sketch the friction for this one, therefore the friction for that would be that way. Instead of sketching it this way, like that, I could sketch my free body diagram, like I said. It will be this angle theta will be theta s plus 10 degrees. And that's my R2. Okay? That may make your free body diagram easier so you have less unknowns to worry about. As far as this particular block is concerned, we're going to be sketching it the same way. We have the force P, and we have R2 heading that way, and this angle P is PS plus 10 degrees. Where's the 10 degrees come from? Again, the PS is due to the angle repulse, and the 10 degrees is due to this particular angle here. And then, again, here is my R1. Impending motion is heading to the right. So my friction here should have been gone to the left, right? Therefore, my R3 is heading that way, and this is equal to PS. And what is my PS? My tension PS is equal to PS. And with that, you can write your equations of motion. I know the book solution that use triangles. Force triangle to solve for this, but we can simply use the summation of forces in the x, summation of forces in the y equal to 0 for the first free body diagram and for the second free body diagram. So the first free body diagram, if I were to look at my corner system in x and y, I have minus r1 cosine ps. In this case, we actually do know what that angle is, 0.25. Plus R2 sine PS plus 10 And that's equal to 0. My forces in the y direction is minus 400 minus R1 sine ds plus R2 cosine ds plus 10. And that's equal to 0. We got two equations and two unknowns. And you can solve for both of them. And I believe you have the answers from the back of your book for this. So the R1 and R2, if I go ahead and look it up. Actually, I'll get you to that later. You can then get R1 and R2. And we could do the same thing for the free body diagram on the left. And then you get two unknowns. R3 and T. I believe you can do the math, so I'm gonna leave the math to you. But again, I just want to show you the concept now. The new concept we talked about. The two angles. And as you can see, what it helps is that it will help you drop the number of free body diagrams down on your free body, on your equations. And that will allow us to solve for it. So what are the angles? Let me give you the answers right now. Or actually the forces. My phi of s is 14.04 degrees. Let's go ahead and box that. And if I go ahead and solve for my R2, my R2 actually ended up as 493 pounds. And if we go ahead and use that to solve for the P is 297 pounds. Is that right? Let me see. Make sure I'm looking at the right. No, sorry, it's 313 pounds. Sorry about that. Okay. And so for any weight problems, you should use the two angles wisely. That way, that will help you reduce the total number of unknowns that you have. Okay?